the shadow of death. Your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life,
by God to share the love of Jesus. It's a really wonderful thing that the Lord never lets go of us. We are always in the grasp of his grace, and it is a wonderful thing because there are so many things that try to pry us out of his hands, but we know that our Lord Jesus is the good shepherd who takes good care of all of his sheep. He calls us all by name, and we are his. I'm so glad that you are his sheep as well, that you are in the grasp of God's grace along with all of the church of God in every time and every place. It's my privilege and honor to serve as your pastor in this way, to bring the word of God and to help lead you in praise. A few things about worship today. First, I'd love it if you would kindly let us know that you are here. So I see that we have a smattering, I think that's the official term, of people from St. Paul's. They must all think that I'm still on vacation. I'm counting who's not here. But it's so good, it's wonderful to see you. But also we have a whole lot of people who are our guests this morning connected to a baptism. And I'm so glad that we are going to be receiving yet another one of God's children, Piper, into his grace today. And so I'd ask that you all let us know that you are here. And here's how you can do that. You can fill out the connection card, our worship connection card. How do you get there? Well, if you have a smartphone, you can scan the QR code that's in the pew racks in front of you, and that will lead you over to that form. If you happen to be out online as part of our virtual worship community today, all you need to do is scan down to the little link that's in the comment section of the Facebook post, and you'll be able to get to that worship connection card. And what's there? Well, it requests your name and some way of being in touch with you and any way that we might be able to serve your spiritual needs here through St. Paul's. So we encourage you to do that at some point in time. Even if you don't fill it out right at this point in time, we'd love to know that you've been with us today. Another thing that we have is our opportunity for tithes and offerings in our worship service. In many congregations, that happens with the help of the usher about two-thirds of the way of the congregation. We don't do that at St. Paul's. We have an offering plate at the door of the church where if you brought an offering with you today, you can leave that there, and we'll be glad to employ that in the work of God's kingdom around here in Saratoga and far, far beyond. But if you haven't brought an offering today but still would like to give one, there's information about how to give electronically at St. Paul's website, spalutheran.org/give. So you could visit that and find out how to do that as well. Thank you so much for your generosity in the ways that you bless the ministry of this congregation and the ministry of the kingdom of God. So back to the reason that we've gathered here today, not for announcements, but about what God has presented to us in his word. This summer, our lectionary, the order of readings that we follow every year, brings us into the gospel according to St. Mark. And as you might remember, about a month ago, we parked ourselves in Mark chapter 6, and we're still in Mark chapter 6. There's Jesus with his face palm, and we're remembering that he has had to teach people in different ways, and he has had to save people in different ways. He's going to do that again today. Mark chapter 6 is a powerhouse of a chapter. I keep reminding you that Mark is not so long of a gospel that you couldn't read through it every week before you came to worship, and I would going to encourage you to do that again. But if you want to just focus on one chapter, you could do a whole lot worse than Mark chapter 6. So that's what we're going to be focusing on today, a really wonderful episode where Jesus says three things that he wants for us to take to our lives as well. Take heart, it is I, do not be afraid. Repeat that after me, would you? Take heart, it is I, do not be afraid. One more time, all together now. Take heart, it is I, do not be afraid, from Mark chapter 6. So, last thing about our worship service, as you have seen, we started with our contemporary instruments, as we do on Sundays. It's a blended worship service. The first part of it is connected to these instruments. The last part of it is connected to a liturgy that we find in our hymnal. Some of you grabbed hymnals on your way in. I'm sure that you did. Others of you say, I have what's up on the screen, and that is true. But if you like to use a book in order to sing along, I invite you during our opening praise in order to go and grab one of those hymnals, Lutheran Service Book, Divine Service 3, page 194 and following, will be our communion liturgy a little bit later on in the worship service. So, with all of that said, may I invite you to stand and join in the gathering prayer. Let us pray together. O Lord, my Creator, Redeemer, and Comforter, as I come to worship you in spirit and in truth, I humbly pray that you would open my heart to the preaching of your word so that I may repent of my sins, believe in Jesus Christ as my only Savior, and grow in grace and holiness. Hear me for the sake of his name. Amen. Our opening song is Christ the Sure and Steady Anchor. God's blessings on your worship this morning. The sure and steady anchor in the fury of the storm. When the winds of doubt blow through me and my sails have all been torn, in the suffering, in the sorrow, when my sinking hopes are few, the sure and steady anchor, while the tempest rages on. When temptation claims the battle, and it seems the night has won, deeper still than Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. I invite the congregation to be seated and for the sermon family to join me here at the baptismal font for the service of the rite of holy baptism, sacrament of holy baptism. Welcome. Our Lord commanded baptism, saying to his disciples in the last chapter of Matthew, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I will be with you always to the very end of the age." The holy apostles of the Lord have written, "The promise is for you and for your children, and baptism now saves you." We also learn from the Word of God that we are all conceived and born sinful, and so we are in need of forgiveness. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin and death and everlasting condemnation, but the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Receive the sign of the Holy Cross both upon your forehead and upon your heart to mark you as one redeemed by Christ the crucified. Amen.
Amen. Hear also how the Lord Jesus Christ has opened the kingdom of God to little children. People were bringing little children to Jesus to have him touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he was indignant. He said to them, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. I tell you the truth, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
It's your task as sponsors, godparents, to confess with the whole church the faith in our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in whose name this child will momentarily be baptized. At all times, after she has been baptized, you should remember her in your prayers, put her in mind of her baptism, and as much as in you lies, give your counsel and aid, especially if, God forbid, she should lose her parents, so that she be brought up in the true knowledge and worship of God, and be taught things like the Ten Commandments, and the Creed, and the Lord's Prayer, and that as she grows in years, you place in her hands the Holy Scriptures, bring her to the services of God's house, and provide for her further instruction in the Christian faith, so that
She comes to the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, and thus, as she abides in her baptismal grace and in communion with the church, she can grow up to lead a godly life to the praise and honor of Jesus Christ. All these things, then, you intend gladly and willingly to do? If so, answer yes with God's help.
Yes, with God's help.
Good. May God enable you both to will and to do this faithful and loving work, and with his grace fulfill what we are unable to do. Amen. In order to implore the blessing of our Lord Jesus Christ upon the gathering of this child into the family of our Father, let us with all the family pray the prayer that he gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord preserve your coming in and your going out from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen. Because this child cannot yet answer for herself, we shall all, together with her parents and godparents, faithfully speak on her behalf, testifying to the forgiveness of sins and the birth of the life of faith which God our Father bestows in and through baptism. And so I ask everyone present, do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways?
I do renounce them.
Good. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty?
Yes, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son?
Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Who brings this child to be baptized?
We do.
I'm so glad you did. Well, how is she to be named?
Piper Wesley Sermon.
Will you take her, Bo? Yes. Thank you. Piper Wesley Sermon, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. All God's people said,
Amen. Amen.
Oh, yeah. Wonderful. May the Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given you this new birth of water and of the Holy Spirit, may he strengthen you with his grace to life everlasting. Peace be with you. Amen. Piper, receive this white garment to show that Christ has taken away and borne all your sins, and he has put upon you his perfect righteousness. So shall you in faith ever stand before him. Receive also this burning light. Live always by the light of Christ, and be ever watchful for his coming, so that you may meet him with joy and enter with him into the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which shall have no end. Amen. Will you hold that, please? Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God and Father, we thank and praise you that you graciously preserve and enlarge your family and have granted Piper Wesley the new birth and holy baptism and made her a member of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir of your heavenly kingdom. We humbly implore you, as she has now become your child, keep her in baptismal grace, and according to your good pleasure, may she faithfully grow to lead a godly life to the praise and honor of your holy name, and finally, with all your saints, obtain the promised inheritance in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord and giver of life, look with kindness upon Brian and Amanda. Let them ever rejoice in the gift of Piper, whom you have given them. Help them to be teachers and examples of righteousness for all their children. Strengthen them in their own baptism, so that they may share eternally with their children the salvation you have given them. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let's welcome Piper and give thanks to God as we sing Children of the Heavenly Father.
Baptism, God has added Piper Wesley Sermon to his own people to declare the wonderful deeds of our Savior, who has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. We welcome you into the Lord's family. We receive you as a fellow member of the body of Christ, a child of the same heavenly Father, to work with us in his kingdom.
May the Lord bless you in all of your ways from this time forth and even forevermore. Go in his peace. Amen. Amen. But before we go in his peace, I have some things to give you. First, you can blow out that candle. However, you have some responsibility. 1 year from now, this girl needs a chocolate cake with that candle right in the middle of it so she can taste and see that the Lord is good and gave her chocolate this way. I'm going to give her back to you because I can't do the rest of the service with her in my arms, even though I would like to. All right, and I have for you some important things. First, we have for you this, which stores the candle. And then we have some things about holy baptism that are important for you as you train her up in the way that she should go. We have the certificate that says this happened this day. So if anybody ever asks, she says, yes, of course it did. This is what we dried her head with after her baptism. There's that baptismal symbol, but her name right there, Piper Wesley Sermon on July 28, 2024. Keep that with the precious things that you have. And privilege as sponsors, you guys over here have made some incredible promises. That is to remind you, keep that in a place where you're going to see it so that you might be able to do all of those things that you committed to and faithfully help her to grow up in this godly life. What a wonderful thing the Lord has done in your family this day. God's blessings with you. Go in his peace. Just back to there.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Almighty and most merciful God, the protector of all who trust in you, strengthen our faith and give us courage to believe that in your love you will rescue us from all adversities. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The Old Testament appointed for today is from Genesis, the 9th chapter. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "Behold, I establish my covenant with you and your offspring after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the livestock, and every beast of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. It is for every beast of the earth, and I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of the flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." And God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all generations. I have set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth, and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." This is the word of the Lord. The epistle is from Ephesians, the 3rd chapter. "For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Stand in honor of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel is according to St. Mark, the 6th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Immediately, Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, to Bethsaida, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had taken leave of them, he went up on the mountain to pray, and when evening came, the boat was out on the sea, and he was alone on the land. And he saw that they were making headway painfully, for the wind was against them. And about the fourth watch of the night, he came to them, walking on the sea. He meant to pass by them, but when they saw him walking on the sea, they thought it was a ghost, and cried out, for they all saw him and were terrified. But immediately he spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." And he got into the boat with them, and the wind ceased. And they were utterly astounded, for they did not understand about the loaves, but their hearts were hardened. When they had crossed over, they came to Gennesaret and moored to the shore. And when they got out of the boat, the people immediately recognized him and ran about the whole region and began to bring the sick people on their beds to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he came, in villages and cities or countryside, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and implored him that they might touch even the fringe of his garment. As many as touched it were made well. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
If you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand?
But with you there is forgiveness. Therefore, you are feared.
Since we are gathered to hear God's word, to call upon him in prayer and in praise, and to receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought and word and in deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together, as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Almighty God, have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you. And for his sake, he forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. Thank you. Let's share that peace with one another.
On the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works, I will meditate.
I will extol you, my God and King, and bless your name forever and ever.
Every day I will bless you and praise your name forever and ever.
Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable.
They shall speak of the might of your awesome deeds, and I will declare your greatness.
They shall pour forth the fame of your abundant goodness, and shall sing aloud of your righteousness.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Grace, mercy, and peace be to all of you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated. You've already memorized the title of the sermon. You've already memorized Mark chapter 6, verse 50. Let's say it together again, and if you need a crutch, it's up there on the screen for you. Ready? Take heart. It is I. Do not be afraid. Is there any more comforting word from our Lord Jesus Christ than these? Take heart. It is I. Do not be afraid. The disciples had plenty of reason to be afraid. They were rowing, more than likely, across the Sea of Galilee, and the wind was preventing them from getting where they were supposed to be going. Their teacher was left with the 5,000 men and the women and the children that he had fed earlier before, and the people who were sworn to defend him as disciples were sent away. No, you go ahead of me. I'll stay here and dismiss the crowds. And then he went up into the mountain to pray, and then when he finally shows up, what do they think he is? A ghost! Oh, it's a ghost on the sea! And don't poo-poo them. Don't think less of them. You'd be terrified too if you saw the things that you saw and heard the things that you had heard and then saw in the middle of the night somebody walking on the water. You just would blow your mind. Sometimes Scripture gives us a little tiny hint of the internal workings of God. And it's holy ground when it does. And you'd read right over it if you didn't slow down and take a minute and think about it. Just before Mark chapter 6, 50, which says, what? Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid. Mark 6, 49 says that Jesus was planning to go on ahead of them and pass them by. Jesus was on his way to a different location, to Gennesaret. He was going to meet them there. That was the original plan. But they caught sight of him on his way and shrieked, thinking he's a ghost. Jesus had two choices at that moment. He could either keep going and leave them in their fear, or he could get in the boat with them and say, take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid. This is the inner workings of God. Our lives are our most important thing. We think of ourselves because the brain is in our head and the heart is in our chest and the hands are at the ends of our arms. We think of ourselves. And even the most selfless among us, I think of moms in this circumstance, they might think their baby is the most important thing. And Piper is pretty critical, isn't she? But she's important to you. She's an extension of you. You'd do anything for her, wouldn't you? We'd do things, incredible things for our spouses and those who love us. We do amazing things to show children that we care for them and want them to be well. We'll even do astounding things for strangers if the opportunity presents itself. But those are our concerns. We don't normally think about it, but God has his own concerns. God is running the universe. All of the things that we can see and things that we can't are his responsibility. They're his creation. Jesus had an agenda. And we heard what he was going to do when he got over to Gennesaret. He was going to heal a bunch of people. But on the way, Jesus was willing to be detained, to slow down, to find terrified people. And he says, you can be of good courage. I'm with you. You don't have to be afraid now or later, because it's me, he says. It's me. Don't you know me? And I think that's our human problem, is that we let our human problems get bigger than the one who made us. We let our human problems become larger than the one who can take them away. But Jesus says, even in that most human of instinct to fear, take heart. It's me. Don't be afraid. While it wasn't John that wrote these words in Mark chapter 6, John was in the boat. And later on in John's life, when he was writing an epistle to the whole church, he wrote these beautiful words: perfect love drives out fear. There are two things that we can do with our fears. We can embrace them and give them power over us. Or we can release them into the hands of the one who has perfect love for us. And more than perfect love, his perfect ability. And more than perfect ability, he has perfect knowledge. And even more than perfect knowledge, he has perfection in himself. And he's willing to give these to you by faith. Because that's what it means to take heart. It's to trust that despite what we're facing, it's God who's with us. To have faith is to trust that anything that we or the world or even the devil can put against us, God is greater than all of these. You see what happened when Jesus got into the boat? Immediately, the wind was stilled. When we release our fears into the hands of the God who made us, who redeemed us, and who has promised to be with us always, even to the end of the age, in every circumstance of our life, in every trouble that we face, even in the face of our own death, we can say, I trust you. I won't be afraid. Take heart, Jesus doesn't just say to his disciples in the boat. He says it to you and me. It's me who's with you. It's God Almighty Jesus Christ, the Lord of heaven and earth, the Holy Spirit who calls and gathers, enlightens and sanctifies us, he's with us. Do not be afraid. And if you're not afraid, is there anything you can't do? If you're not afraid, isn't it true that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you? It's great that Jesus doesn't pass us by in our fears. He doesn't pass us by in our faults. He doesn't pass us by in our failings. He doesn't pass us by in our frailty. He gets in the boat with us and whispers to our hearts those beautiful words that I want you to take home with you, tuck in your heart, put on your mirror, write on the palm of your hand, whatever it is that you need to do to remember. Take heart. It is I. Do not be afraid. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise as we sing Christ, our hope in life and death.
Feast in endless joy.
Sometimes a shriek from a boat is as much of a prayer as the Our Father is. Our Lord hears our sighs, reads our fears, even before we are able to elucidate them for ourselves, which is why he's given us the gift of prayer, to know that he is with us in our prayers, in our fears, our adversities. Everything that we face is our great hope, and it is our simple faith that he hears and answers our prayers. As a community of faith, it's also a comforting thing to know that we're together with him, with each other, that we are part of the ways that God brings encouragement and hope into desperate and fear-filled situations, which is why we always invite the congregation to share prayer requests, because as a congregation, we pray. We call on our Lord in hope and trust and confidence that he is not far from us, that he gets into the boat of these circumstances and with his mercy does what we ourselves are unable to do. Prayer is the gift of terrified and hopeless people, except that we are not fearful, though the earth gives way, and even if mountains are thrown into the heart of the sea, because God is with us. Take heart. It is I. Do not be afraid. So if you're not going to be afraid, you know what else you can do? Not only all things through Christ who gives us strength, calling on God in order to give the help that he alone can give. So please send your prayer requests our way. Best way to do that is prayer@spalutheran.org, an email to that address. We'll get it into the hands of people who have promised to pray. If you're out there on our live stream, you can also put those prayer requests in the comment section. We do go through them and glean them out and pray for them. And I invite all of you to join, hopefully, at our Monday Connect, 10:30 on Monday mornings, although this week we are not going to be having a Monday Connect on at that time. We'll be having a funeral instead. You might have come to know that our sister in Christ, Peggy Florence, has gone home to be with Jesus. He has gotten into the boat with her through death and brought her into the safety of the harbor of life everlasting. What a wonderful gift of life and faith he has given her, and what a wonderful gift of faith that we have, that we can worship together and say, we'll see her and Jesus together again. So if you have the opportunity to join for that funeral, you're all welcome to do so tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. here at the church is the service. And is that right? 10 a.m. for the service, 9 a.m. for visitation with the family beforehand. So, bearing these and all other things in our minds and hearts, we come before the Lord, calling upon him for the help that he alone can give. Let us pray for the whole church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs, saying, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you have made us your own dear children through holy baptism. Strengthen us in our inner being by the power of your Holy Spirit so that your Son will dwell in our hearts through faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, you are able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think. Be glorified in your church and in Christ Jesus. Ground us in love. Give us a faith rooted in the promises of Christ and strength to comprehend with all the saints his love that surpasses all knowledge. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, as you preserve Noah and his family in the ark, bless and preserve the families of our congregation and Christian Childhood Center. Strengthen marriages and parenting, and let the word of Christ dwell richly in all, uniting them in love for you and one another. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord of might, spare us and every future generation from wickedness. Call forth righteous people from every corner of our nation who will serve as noble leaders that pray for your blessing and gladly devote themselves to the well-being of their fellow citizens. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we, your people, cry out for your healing. Bless all those in need, especially these we remember before you. Just as Jesus did during his earthly ministry, heal them and make them whole. Bless them to trust in your love, that you will never leave them or forsake them. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O Lord, as we approach your altar to protect and defend our hearts from becoming hardened by indifference to holy things or by the frustrations and sorrows of this world and life, by eating and drinking your holy blood and your holy body and precious blood, refresh our faith and renew our hope that you have overcome sin and death, and that in you we are more than conquerors. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you name every family in heaven and on earth. We give thanks for our brothers and sisters in Christ who have finished their course in faith and now rest from their labors. Preserve us in the faith so that Christ may dwell in our hearts richly until the great and glorious day we join with them around your throne. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand as we approach the table of our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is meet and right so to do. It truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death in the grave and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, he gave it for them all to drink, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." It is I. Do not be afraid. Here Jesus has located himself in the humble gifts of bread and wine so that we might take and eat and see and taste and see that the Lord is good. We come in order to have our sins forgiven, our faith restored, and our hope built up for the great feast that awaits us in heaven. As you come to the table, you can receive the body of Christ either into your hand or directly into your mouth, according to your preference. The blood of Christ is available from individual glasses or from a common cup. If you prefer the individual glass, please take that and commune right away once you receive it. If instead you prefer the individual cup, that will follow. Please grasp the base of the chalice and tilt it to your lips and thereby assist in the distribution. If for whatever reason it is not your inclination in order to receive the body and blood of Jesus, we still invite you to the altar to receive a spoken blessing. Please indicate that you prefer that by placing your finger in front of your lips like this or your hands across your chest like this. The gifts of God are prepared for the people of God, the people of God prepared for his gifts. Come, for all things are now ready. Amen.
All who are able, please stand. Give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good,
and his mercy endureth forever.
Let us pray together. We give thanks to you, Almighty God. You have refreshed us through this salutary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same, in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Bless we the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Our closing hymn, Lord, dismiss us with your blessing, 924. Gathered by God
to share the love of Jesus.
Go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.